Hi guys, welcome to my channel Mother's Flavor and my name is Nikita and today's recipe is vegetable sambar. Here I am using normal vegetables like beans, carrot and loki. You can add any kind of vegetable that you like in this sambar and do it the similar way that I have done it in this recipe. So to make vegetable sambar, we need the following ingredients. Firstly, we need about 1 tablespoon of oil. If you want, you can even use ghee. I am using only oil here. We'll need 1 teaspoon of Jeera and 1 teaspoon of mustard seeds. We'll need about 1/2 teaspoon of Hing, 4 cloves of crushed garlic, 1 medium-sized onion which I have chopped, 1 medium-sized tomato which I have chopped, 1 medium-sized carrot which I have chopped, 10 to 11 beans again chopped, 1 teaspoon of Dhaniya powder, 1/2 tablespoon of Garam masala, 1 tablespoon of Sambar powder. If you don't have Sambar powder, you can skip the Sambar powder and add more chili powder and add about 1 tablespoon of chili powder and 1/2 tablespoon of Dhaniya powder. Salt to taste, 1/4 cup of dal which I have soaked in water, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder and some chopped coriander leaves for garnishing. And I have also taken loki here. I'm only going to be using 1/2 of a loki. If you want, you can use other vegetables also like aloo or drumsticks. I'm going to make vegetable sambar in cooker here. So first we will heat our cooker. So once our cooker is heated, we'll add in our oil. Once our oil is heated, we'll add in our jeera and mustard seeds. Now if it starts fluttering, we'll add in our ghee. Flame on medium when you're doing all of this. Now we'll add in our garlic. Give it one nice mix. Before your garlic turns brown in color, add in your onion. Saute your onion till they turn transparent in color. We'll add in our tomatoes. While our tomato is cooking, turn your flame to full low. And now while your tomato is cooking, I will chop our loki. I haven't chopped the loki beforehand because loki, if you chop it and keep it before, it ends up becoming bitter and your sambar will turn bitter. That is why I'm going to chop it now. I have chopped my loki now. I have actually picked the loki using a peeler and then I have chopped it. And I haven't even de-seeded it. Some people prefer to actually take out the seed bit of it. Like it that way, you can do that way as well, but I really prefer to keep those also, so it's again to your choice. Now once your tomato is become slightly soft, we'll add in our dhaniya powder, garam masala powder, turmeric powder and our sambar powder. I have a video on how to make sambar powder as well. You guys can check out that video, it will be there, it will be linked in the description box below. Now we'll add in all our vegetables and give it one nice mix. I'll just add water now. I'll add in the dal. Here I'm using Toor dal. You can use any other dal. You can even use dal or chana dal as well. Many people don't like loki, so they end up not using it, but it is very good for your health. It has a lot of nutritional value. Now, after adding the dal, we'll add the salt. One nice mix. We'll close the cooker lid and we'll let it cook on medium flame for about 5 whistles. Here I have soaked the dal, so I'm just cooking it for 5 whistles. If you haven't soaked your dal, then you can cook it for around 7 to 8 whistles. So now after 5 whistles, we'll turn off our heat. We'll let the cooker cool down. Now our cooker has cooled down and it has also released all its pressure. So we'll take off the lid. As you can see, our dal and our sabzi has cooked really well. So now we'll transfer this into our serving bowl. Serve it. Garnish it with some coriander leaves and ghee. So there you go. Our vegetable sambar is ready.
I hope you guys really enjoyed the video. If you really liked the video, then do hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you.